Clicking the Unit Processes button on the main menu screen will take you to the Unit Processes list screen. Alternatively, you can drill down to a specific unit process record by following the blue links from an emission unit. If you are coming from the main menu screen, the resulting list view shows all of the unit processes for the facility. If there are more than 100 records, there will be multiple pages of results. The list can be filtered by typing in the filter box. The filter looks at all of the data displayed in the columns to determine a match. If desired, the columns can be sorted by clicking on a header. Near the bottom left, there is an export button. The export button generates CSV files that provide a different and more detailed view of the list results. This is especially useful if there are a large number of items in the list. Please note, this is an optional way of viewing unit process data and not a required action. Clicking the magnifying glass button for a record results in a view-only screen for the selected record. No changes can be made on the view-only screen. Clicking the gear button results in an edit mode screen that allows data to be edited and saved. Notice that there are tabs across the top of the screen. Update information on each tab and click the Save button. SLEIS will pinpoint any errors or omissions during the save process. Fix errors and save again. Fields with red bars are required fields. Clicking a green question mark will trigger a pop-up help screen. If it is necessary to change the SEC for the unit process, you must also examine the process emissions level and compare any existing pollutants and factors to these factor spreadsheets and update the process emissions accordingly. Please see the video titled Process Emissions for more information on factors and pollutant emissions. If the SCC is known, it can be entered directly on the Unit Process tab. Alternatively, you can use the drop-down menus to drill down to the desired SCC. The last/final emissions year is only applicable when the process will no longer be operating, effectively shutting down the process for good. Once this field has been filled in and the inventory transmitted to the department, the process cannot be reopened, so be sure that the process is permanently closed before using this field. If the process did not operate during the reporting year, but is not permanently shut down, use the comments block to indicate that condition. You will also need to go to the related process emissions record and update the annual throughput to zero, the actual hours to zero, and zero out the emissions for any manually calculated pollutants. Please see the video titled Process Emissions for information on editing those data items. As referenced previously, use the comments block to add any pertinent information about this item. On the Control Approach tab, please make sure that the appropriate devices are linked to the process. EPA data systems now handle controls differently than in the past. The control approach is the overall control method that has been applied to a process and includes any and all controls. Controls, however, are not listed individually, only their collective type. For example, if your process is controlled by three baghouses, you would create and link one device labeled Process XYZ Baghouses, instead of creating each of the three baghouses individually and linking those to the process. The control approach description should reflect the overall methods of control used on the process. To remove the linked control device from the process, click the trash can to the right of the linked device. To go directly to the linked control devices page, click the gear button. Once on the control devices page, you can edit the device's properties and pollutants. See the video titled Control Devices for information on this process. Click the appropriate blue link under Related Unit Processes to return to the linked unit process. Be sure any control device changes have been saved prior to clicking the Related Unit Processes link. The Release Point Apportionment tab shows the release points that the process is vented through. SLEIS allows a process to vent through more than one release point. You can link additional stacks by clicking the button with the plus sign. To edit the linked release points parameters, click the gear button to the left of the release point. be sure any release point apportionment changes have been saved prior to clicking the gear button. Click the appropriate blue link under Related Unit Processes to return to the linked unit process. Be sure any release point changes have been saved prior to clicking the Related Unit Processes link. If you need to add a unit process, click the Add button on the bottom right of the Unit Processes list screen. When adding a new unit process, a process emissions record is also created automatically. Please see the video titled Process Emissions to learn about adding applicable pollutants and factors to the process emissions level. The unit process identifier can be any numerical value between 1 and 999. Please look at the Unit Processes list screen and select the next sequential numerical value that you see. Remember to hit Save, or any changes will be lost if you navigate away from the page. There is no save warning. If you wish to see the emissions unit that the unit process is associated with, use the blue links listed near the top of the screen on the Unit Process tab. These are a direct link to the connected emission unit for the current unit process record. Conversely, you can also get to a specific unit process record from the emissions unit screen by using the blue links on those screens. Use the blue back arrow to return to the unit processes list screen. Use the blue back arrow again to return to the main menu screen.